Hello everyone. Welcome to Learnaholic India. Today we are going to learn SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, which is application layer protocol from computer network. The topics that we are going to learn in today's session are: what is SMTP? Components of SMTP and working of SMTP. So without wasting time, let's start with today's session. First of all, the question arises: what is SMTP? SMTP stands for Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. SMTP is a set of communication guidelines that allow software to transmit an electronic mail over the internet is called Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. It is a program used for sending messages to other computer users based on email addresses. It provides a mail exchange between users on the same or different computers. Now let's see SMTP supports. SMTP can send a single message to one or more recipients. Sending message can include text, voice, video or graphics. It can also send the messages on networks outside the internet. Now let's see purpose of SMTP. The main purpose of SMTP is used to set up communication rules between servers. The servers have a way of identifying themselves and announcing what kind of communication they are trying to perform. They also have a way of handling the errors such as incorrect email address. For example, if the recipient address is wrong, then receiving server reply with an error message of some kind. Now let's see which are the components of SMTP. First, we will break the SMTP client and SMTP server into two components, such as user agent, that is UA, and mail transfer agent, that is MTA. The user agent prepares the message, creates the envelope and then puts the message in the envelope. The mail transfer agent transfers this mail across the internet. SMTP allows a more complex system by adding a relaying system. Instead of just having one MTA at sending side and one at receiving side, more MTAs can be added, acting either as a client or server to relay the email. The relaying system without TCP/IP protocol can also be used to send the emails to users. And this is achieved by the use of the mail gateway. The mail gateway is a relay MTA that can be used to receive an email. Let's see how does SMTP work. There are basically 5 steps. We will see each and every step in detail. First step is composition of mail. In this step, a user sends an email by composing an electronic mail message using a mail user agent, that is MUA. Mail user agent is a program which is used to send and receive mail. The message contains 2 parts, body and header. The body is the main part of the message, while the header includes information such as the sender and recipient address. The header also includes descriptive information such as the subject of the message. In this case, the message body is like a letter and header is like an envelope that contains the recipient's address. Second step is submission of mail. After composing an email, the mail client then submits the completed email to the SMTP server by using SMTP on TCP port 25. Third step is delivery of mail. Email addresses contain 2 parts, username of the recipient and domain name. For example, prateek@gmail.com, where Prateek is the username of the recipient and gmail.com is the domain name. If the domain name of the recipient's email address is different from the sender's domain name, then MSA will send the mail to the mail transfer agent, that is MTA. To relay the email, the MTA will find the target domain. It checks the MX record from domain name system to obtain the target domain. The MX record contains the domain name and IP address of the recipient's domain. Once the record is located, MTA connects to the exchange server to relay the message. Fourth step is receipt and processing of mail. Once the incoming message is received, the exchange server delivers it to the incoming server, that is mail delivery agent, which stores the email where it waits for the user to retrieve it. Fifth and last step is access and retrieval of mail. In this step, the stored email in MTA can be retrieved by using MUA, that is mail user agent. MUA can be accessed by using login and password. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Social media links are given in the description below. If you like today's video, then like it, share with your friends. If you have any query, then please comment below. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.